Good morning, everybody. Pretty good looking firsthand. So yeah, this is the first time I've ever played against EWL. Doesn't have very many games played, but he's got a pretty good win-loss record. Yeah, I really have a lot of ops this hand. Want to get this Romanian abdication out as fast as I can. And also I want to be the first one to do a space race attempt with the AI war. Even though I don't have any influence in Israel, I still want to, unless he hits this first space race box, I guess even then I think I still want to space it. He gets one VP on average if I don't have any adjacency to block it. That stinks. I couldn't get out the Romanian abdication before the independent reds came out. I mean, I had the opportunity to do it, but I just wanted to get a little bit of adjacency while I could. Actually, maybe I won't space that. Really feel like I need the ops. Even though I had a ton of ops this turn. Yeah, I think I might actually play it for ops. Even though I really want to get to that first space race box first. We still have a lot of dangerous cards. We have De Gaulle, Socialist Governments. And if this turn ends with DEFCON at 3 and goes up to 4, he's going to get a coup in Thailand. So I really would like to have 4 in Thailand. And 5 in France and 4 in Italy. Yeah, I definitely want to put 2 in Italy because socialist governments and a 3 drop flips Italy right there. Wow. I can't believe I had so many ops in my hand and I still felt like I didn't have enough. I guess putting 1 in Iraq was kind of a waste. I kind of wish I had that one back. Maybe I shouldn't put 2 in Italy. I mean, I want to put 2 in Thailand and I mean, if he gets socialist governments, I could just, you know, let him take it and just hope he can't. Socialist governments headline. The reason I put one in Jordan is because kind of puts him in a tough spot as far as Middle East domination. I know it's a non-battleground, but he has to spend three ops to get domination now instead of two. Korean War is about to get shuffled back in, so I don't want to set myself up for it too much, but this isn't that bad. I don't want to put any more in South Korea while the Korean War is still unremoved. Might even think about taking Taiwan. Hopefully I can just hold on to the China card for a long time. There's really, you know, hopefully no need for me to play it at all this game, and I can just hold on to that Formosan resolution the whole time. Oh man, I didn't even notice that Europe got evened out. I got lucky that he didn't have that scorecard. I wasn't even paying attention. Would have made more sense for me to get back Europe domination than it did to take Taiwan there. I got away with one. Yeah, my opponent's playing pretty tough so far. I've had some pretty good cards, but he's got a pretty good setup over here with the D-stall. Okay, so he's got the 5-year plan and Europe scoring combo, so he can use the 5-year plan to discard Europe scoring. Yeah, you got a ton of value out of that Red Scare Purge. I should probably just headline the South America scoring. Before South America gets any worse, I don't have any access cards for it either. Hopefully I can double space, that would be nice. Probably end up holding AI war or salt negotiations. It would be really nice to space these two cards if I can get that off. Oh, that's not good. Probably space liberation theology and hold South African unrest. Thank you. You know, I could salt Voice of America here. Kind of like that. I guess I probably should have done that on the last AR. Fuck, I mean, if I hit the space race, I could get one small step. That might even be better. If I could hit that third space race box and one small step over there, that might be even better. After I event the one small step, I won't be able to space two op cards anymore, but the only red twos left in the deck anyway are Willy Brandt, Portuguese Empire, and Korean War, and none of those are so awesome for me to space now anyway. And IP Wars in the discard pile. That was a pretty strange play there. I could just scrap the whole thing and nah, I really want that one small step. I think I like it even more than VOA. The other nice thing about eventing salt is that now I got the opportunity to get mill ops when I didn't before. I didn't have any cards that could give me mill ops, and he doesn't have any non-battlegrounds that I can coup. And I really don't want to get burned on mill ops this turn. I really want to throw away three here. There's exactly three scorecards left. I mean, it would be insane if I drew all three scorecards and threw away three here. That would be just insane, right? I should be good to just throw away three, I think. I know it's, like, sort of risky, but I don't like any of these cards. I think I'm just going to take the little risk that I don't draw three scorecards here. Yeah, if I had drawn three scorecards in a row out of 39 card stub, that would have been just we would have had to put that on the highlight reel. I mean, that's not the only horrible thing that could happen to me though. I mean, I could draw something like lone gunmen, socialist governments, quagmire, OPEC, like some horrible combination. But it's pretty unlikely. I mean, they're really. I know you guys can't see the whole card counter, but there really aren't that many terrible cards for me left in the deck, besides the ones that I just named. And there's a lot of really good cards left in the deck, too, like ABM, Brush War, Junta, stuff like that. Colonial Rear Guards, Grain Sales. I guess ABM wasn't in the deck. It really wasn't a great draw for me. Oh, he didn't even event that. Interesting. Okay, so I just gotta event one small step here, right? No. Yes. Nice. The only card that sucks. Can't do anything but return the UN intervention. That's the second time I've pulled that in the last week. I almost want to say that's the second time in a row I've pulled that off of grain sales. That might not be right though, but it feels like it. even though South America scoring is gone and Central America scoring is still out, I still kind of want to brush war right here because it's a 2-for-1. Also, Mexico's pretty realignable. Wow. Yeah, I think I'm gonna go for Argentina with the brush war. still haven't seen OPEC yet, and Egypt is an OPEC country. I really don't have enough ops to take Chile. Maybe even if I play the China card, I might still not have ops. And I really don't want to play the China card here. I want to just hold the How I Learned to Stop Worrying. We haven't seen Lone Gunman yet either. Okay, he took it back anyway. I'm cool with that. I should just dump Southeast Asia scoring. Starting to get some realigns set up, and I'm not too far away from more realigns. Mexico's another place I want to realign. So, might have some potential realigns coming right up here. Really want to realign Mexico. Oh, I just remembered I could have just discarded the Lone Gunman at the end of the turn. Well, I guess if I just hold Quagmire, I could discard the Quagmire at the end of the turn, so I guess that's cool too. Yeah, I can't space the Quagmire and the Opec. Alright, I guess this is good. Still haven't seen Junta yet, or Muslim Revolution, and the only scorecard out is Central America, but, I don't know. Fidel's in the discard pile, so I don't really want to take Cuba. And it's only, like, gives me one more point anyway. I guess if I can flip Mexico or Panama and then take Cuba, I would have domination. You know, I might not want to space this Muslim revolution actually, because if I hit it, I won't be able to space three ops anymore, and now that one small step is gone anyway, I don't really have to worry about getting overtaken in the space race anyway. This sure is a weird hand. So probably my best chance at this point is to get a DEF CON win, and I think the Nixon headline is the best way to do that. And if I event the bear trap at the end of this turn, so that he's bear trapped at the beginning of turn 10, and then I can lower the DEF CON to 2 before he gets the chance to play his first action round on turn 10. It gives me a pretty decent setup for a for an attempt at a DEF CON win. I don't want to see duck and cover in my hand, but we still have CIA, grain sales, Star Wars, tear down this wall. I mean, we definitely got a shot at it. What a risky headline by him there. If I headline duck and cover, that's game. Super risky headline play there by him. That was weird. You know, I'm minding up Space Race in this War Games. I've never actually made it to the end of the Space Race before, but I might actually do it this time. Might be worth one. Oh, I guess I should have waited on that in case Iron Lady event came out. There's a decent chance he's got Iron Lady in his hand. Didn't think of that in time. Oh well. Thank you. Yeah, that DEFCON win came through. That was a tough one. Those DEFCON cards came through for me. Thanks for watching, everybody. That was a game with a lot of discarded scoring cards. I don't think Europe didn't get scored that entire game. And he didn't have it in his hand. That would have been crazy if Europe doesn't get scored the entire game until final scoring. I don't think I've ever seen that before. I thought my opponent played really well, except for that one Olympic Games headline right here. This is kind of insane, especially because it's not risky for me to headline a card like Duck and Cover, because We Will Bury You is gone, so Duck and Cover is a totally legit headline for me to headline right here. Anyway, yeah, that was a wild one. Thanks for watching, everybody. Back up to 2 and 3 in OTSL Season 2 now. After my 0-3 start. So yeah, I'm on a pretty good streak. The only game I've lost lately is the one I lost to Charcoal Yik in the tournament yesterday. And I never did look to see who won that tournament. I need to look at that. But I think in my last 10 games I won 9 of them. So yeah, I'm on a pretty good streak.